Just when I thought I was out, they pulled me back in.
The biggest, most outrageous online show in Philippine history.
20 million fucking downloads.
Interactive in 35 countries. Mo is back with a vengeance in Season 2. Bigger, better, badder.
Let's start off with an international call. Yesterday we took a call from India. Tonight it's Canada.
Nice.
Let's go to Ireland. Where in Ireland are you?
Well, I'm in Dublin.
Some people say that I'm a bad guy.
Let's go to Afghanistan. Holy shit, are you fucking really in Afghanistan?
Yeah, man, what's up?
Florida, what's up?
Listen, I just found your show today, and I think it's great.
Live from Hollywood and at the Beyond the Box Studios in One Rockwell, Makati, it's Good Times with Mo, the podcast, Season 2, the Bigger, Better, Badder podcast. Your questions about love, life, sex. Are all answered and occasionally made fun of here. And now, the man who loves women and dudes, but not in the same way, the Philippine genius, DJ Mo Twister.
All right, here we go. Welcome back to the podcast. When I say welcome back, I'm talking about like we haven't done this shit in one whole year. As we kick off season number two, I want to thank all of you for being patient with us as it has been longer than promised, but at least the promise is fulfilled. We are back on the program, and we are here to save the world for you people. Of course, our phone number, if you want to get in touch with us, it is new. So write it down, tattoo it on your arm, whatever the fuck you want to do. It's 478-7954. My name is Mo, and welcome to Good Times with Mo, the podcast, Season 2. A little bit of changes from the last season. Obviously, I'm broadcasting now from Los Angeles, no longer in the booth there. Now, you can't see me yet. Because we haven't worked out the studio in this Los Angeles party with the video cameras and stuff. So what you'll see are the doctor, the new doctor on the show, as well as our celebrity guest. So that tonight is John Lapus. John, what is it? Good evening in your part of the world.
Good morning here. Good evening, Mo. And ano oras ba dyan sa LA? Good morning. Tama ba ako?
It's like 5:45 in the morning. It's some crazy time. But you know what? That's what's great about podcasts because it's an online show. So there's really no time. I mean, we can say the date. Obviously, it is the 17th of December as we kick off season two of the program. Now, you were one of our regular guests
in the last podcast. I know. And I'm so happy to be back. And I'm so honored and flattered at the same time. Na I'm your first guest for your second season, diba? What a way to launch your second season.
And there's a lot of things going on in your life, in your career, John, that we'll talk about today while taking calls from our listeners. But let's also introduce the doctor. He is Dr. Ken.
Yeah.
Ken, thanks for being here.
Kamusta? How are you doing?
Doc Ken in the house.
I'm doing great.
Kamusta, John? Kamusta mo?
Yeah, you look like a young guy. You look like a. I mean, how did you get involved in this podcast? I know you're friends with Basti. Is that the connection here?
Well, the connection is Riza, Basti's wife, is my patient, and that's how it started. Yeah, they said that they needed a doctor, and then I was up to it. So here I am.
All right.
Hindi, yeah,
you're a young guy. I think we're the same age or something like that. You guys look alike, you and John.
Mo katulad ng mga past doctors mo, mukhang malibog rin to eh. So bagay to doon dito sa
medyo, tama ka dyan.
Itsura pa lang eh. Pagpasok pa lang kanina, nako.
Medyo formal pa eh. Pero
sex doctor talaga eh. Sabi, parang ayata siya or surgeon. Parang pero tinitingnan ko, pwede rin sex doctor.
That's what I've always wanted to ask doctors. Because you see so many people nude and they're sick and like they've got really weird shit wrong with them. Do you ever kind of, does the sex drive go down if you're a doctor? Because araw-araw, nakita mo yung mga genitals or whatever kind of sickness they have, and you're like, I don't want to fuck another human being. Like it's disgusting already.
That's not true, and that's absolutely false. Hindi totoo yun. Na unless you are an OB guy ni na, for example, kanina nakikinig ako ng I was listening to Magic 89.9, and their guest is a guy ni. And he said that he's been doing it for 26 years.
A lalaki na gayni.
Lalaking gayni. Tapos parang gano'n na nga. Sabi niya
na.
Parang hindi na niya. Parang gano'n ang pagkakaintindi ko.
Pero ako nawi-weird ako sa lalaking gayni. Di ba parang kung babae ako, eh lalaki yung doktor.
Yes,
bakit gano'n?
Nung una kasi, lahat ng mga doktor, karamihan lalaki.
Na gayni.
Even OBs were men. And then, nawala sa lap, naging panay babae. May natitira pa.
You know what I would do though if I was a gynecologist? Like, I would charge more kung pangit ka. Tapos kung maganda ka, mas mababa yung rate, di ba? I mean, kasi, you know, I have to go through more torture if I see an ugly diseased vagina. Anyway, enough about medicine shit. We have a ton of calls here tonight on the program as we kick off season two of this podcast. Now, we have some pretty great prizes as well for Caller of the Night. The Globe iPhone 5 recently launched in the Philippines.
Awesome.
A huge success for Globe because the iPhone 5 is such a big deal around the world. And finally, it's in the Philippines. Globe is bringing it to you and we're bringing it to you. And not only are we going to give you a phone, if you win it, we're going to give you 1 year paid bill. It's meaning you don't have to fucking pay a thing for one whole year. It's a 2,500 peso plan per month, and all of that shit is waived, and it's for fucking free. That's what we love
about it. Naman, Globe. So,
pero ba manalo?
Oo, Globe. Baka nakakaluwag-luwag naman kayo. Diyos ko, luma na to. Ano, iPhone 4 pa lang tong gamit. Kung gusto ko na nang itapon.
Well, we'll see, depending on your performance. But let's get to these calls, because people are waiting. And again, the phone number, it's new, so write it down, 478-7954. I'm feeling a little bit under the weather today, but no worries. It's really exciting. I'm just really excited to be here. And I want to thank all the people who have bothered me throughout the years saying, where the fuck is the podcast? You got to get it back. I want to thank the people who are online right now watching this live. We appreciate you guys very much. So some of these people have been on hold for like fucking 45 minutes or even longer than that. So let's get to these calls. Let's start with the guy who's been here the longest. Joshua, you're 25. You're from Quezon City. Joshua, you have a question for the three of us, and welcome to the podcast. You're the first caller for season two. Josh?
Hello?
Hey, Josh, what's up? 25. Hey. You have
Hello.
A question.
Hello, good evening.
What's up, Josh?
Good evening, Joshua. Welcome.
Actually, my name is not Josh.
Oh,
my
what?
Name is John.
John.
John, John. Oh, okay, John. We're taking... Okay, you're 42 from Mandaluyong. I'm sorry. I was supposed to take Josh.
Mandaluyong City.
Yeah.
Oh, welcome
right, John,
back, Mo.
42. What's
after
up?
1 year.
Thank you, man. Ah, fuck, man. It took forever. But thank you so much. It's nice to have you on the show.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I mean, I say it over and over. You hear it on the introduction. John, Ken, fucking 20 million downloads in season one.
That's congratulations.
Congratulations.
Fantastic.
Let's make season two 40 million downloads.
Yeah, hopefully. We'll see. All right.
All right.
John, you have a problem. What's going on?
Yeah, I wanted to share something about condoms.
Okay. Sure.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Go ahead.
Gumamit ako ng condoms before, no? Gumamit ako ng condom kasi parang na-curious kami nung girlfriend ko dati. So, gumamit ako, no? So, ang feeling ba nung condom talaga bang parang kulang ka sa sensation, gano'n? Kulang ng libog, gano'n? Wala. Di tulad ng dati.
No, kasi libog, no. Well, John, libog is not naman based on sensation. It's based on like before you get to the actual part, diba? Kasi kung malibog ka, eh, you know, it doesn't mean that, you know, your dick's inside a vagina the whole time. But yeah, it's gonna take away sensation because you have something there, a barrier there between
cover, something in between,
yeah, between your penis
rubber.
And the inside of the vagina, right? And you know, the condom technology has gotten a lot better than in the past. I mean, you're talking in the late 1800s, they were using like fucking rubber from tires. You know what I mean? Like a rubber you would find on a bottle for a baby. That's what they were using in the late 1800s. And if you even go way before that, in hundreds and hundreds of years ago, they were using weird fucking material for condoms. So condoms condom technology is great now. The thing is, nothing beats removing it. Now, you can use it, or you should use a condom to protect yourself from STIs or sexually transmitted infections. But if you have a girlfriend, you're monogamous, you guys are not fucking around, and you just don't want to get pregnant, then go with a birth control pill. So at least you can pull that condom out and you can fuck all day and you know, get the pure sensation that you want.
Ako hindi ko yata ma-imagine yung condom. Di ba talagang sa ayaw mo at sa gusto? Parang wala eh. Mababawasan
well, John,
talaga eh.
John,
I would have to agree with that. Kasi imagine mo na lang, John, mangulangot ka tapos maglagay ka ng plastic sa daliri mo.
Mahirap.
Di ba? Hindi mo makukuha eh.
Correct.
But with regards
That's
to the
right.
with the contraception
nice
pills,
reference, Doc.
Ang ano nun, it's just an analogy. But ang problem naman sa contraceptive pills, sometimes nagda-dry up yung vagina ng babae. So,
yeah, you know, sometimes side effect they get fat.
No? Sometimes, you know, but you get big things. Sometimes they get big boobs.
Oh, mag-condom ka na lang.
Yeah, but it's better.
Yeah,
no?
And you can put. Yeah. No, why would you do that? Because you can. If listen, if it's for your girlfriend only, right? For your girlfriend that you're not cheating on, she's not fucking another guy. Why don't you do the birth control pills and then just put a lubrication, and then you're gonna get the same fucking. You'll fix the problem of dryness.
Yes, you're
like,
right.
My thing with condoms is to protect yourself from sexually transmitted diseases. That's like for its use. If you are in a relationship where you guys are just the both of you, monogamous. Now, if you're in a relationship like John Lapus here na apatang kinakantot in any given week, kailangan talaga ng condom because, you know, what kind of fucking disease John might have. Now, John, no, I'm honest.
Nakakaloka ka.
You fucking liar. John, you before the show, you were saying you have 5 guys on rotation.
Regular. You have sex with. Pero,
regular,
ako,
right.
I don't go, hindi ako nagpapainal sex, alam mo naman yan, di ba?
I know, but do you use a condom when you're like blowjobbing and all of that?
Alam naman, blowjobbing ko lang yung lalaki, maglalagay pa ako ng condom para kung kumain ng ng plastic balloon, ano ba yun?
Saging na may balas.
I know, but aren't you scared of getting super singaw in your mouth or something like
that? That is why I have regular small twister. These are kilala ko na mga guys, friends of mine na they are not as hindi sila call boy, di ba? Yung hindi nila trabaho ang makipag-sex on a regular basis sa isang bakla or sa isang matrona.
Pero are these 5 guys only having sex with you or may mga ibang medyo
like
executive na bakla sa ABS?
I wish and I pray na sa akin lang sila nakipagtalik, no? Anyway, si John na caller.
Pero in-inspect mo. Oh no, ini-inspect mo yung titi nila pag nakita mo na,
Malalaman naman eh. At saka sobrang naman ako nakakaloka ka naman. Hindi naman malandila ako, pero hindi naman ako malibo.
I just care for you, my friend. And I don't want all of a sudden may makikita ko, may mga mushroom na sa mukha dahil may...
I'll just add my 2 cents on the topic mo, ah. Since I'm an eye doctor and an eye surgeon and we're talking about these sexually transmitted infections, I just like for everybody to know that there are types of sexually transmitted infection that if you put in your eye, halimbawa natalsikan ka sa mata, mabubulag ka. Because, for example, gonorrhea, bacteria can penetrate an intact epithelium and melt your cornea in 2 to 3 days.
Buti na lang pala pag bumuklaw siya ba ako, bumipikit akong gano'n.
Tama yun. That's right. Tama yun.
But Ken, one of the favorite moves of guys is to ejaculate on someone's face. I mean, that's a great move. So yeah, you're saying, dapat mag-goggles ka, halimbawa nagsiswimming ka, or as John does it, close your eyes.
Close your eyes.
Hindi lahat naman ng sexually transmitted infection ay nakakapag-penetrate ng intact epithelium ng cornea. Pero gonorrhea is one of them. Mm-mm. I have seen a lot in where I trained. I trained in UPPGH. Mm-mm. And that's it.
What a shithole.
Natutunaw dyan.
It melts. Mga girls at saka mga gays alike, alam nyo na, pag yung boyfriend ninyo, yung sex partner ninyo, yung mga lalaki, di ba, trip nga yung dun sa mukha talaga nagpapalabas?
Pwede.
Pikit na lang po kayo para sigurado.
O kaya, pwede huwag kang pumikit. Mag-goggles ka kung gusto mo.
Pwede rin, goggles or shades. O basta dyan, na caller from Mandaluyong, magbasa ka dahil pumasa na ang RH bill kanina lamang. Finally, sa after third reading, ha? Para malaman mo kung saan ang gamit talaga ng condom.
Yes.
All right, John. Thanks for the call.
Sa anong nangyari kasi sa akin, nasanay ako na walang condom, then suddenly gumamit ako ng condom.
Of course.
So, iba yung yung feeling ko ba, ganun?
Of
course.
Parang
kulang sa sensation pag gumamit ng condom, parang yun.
You know, John, if you have the money, no, there are some high quality condoms out there coming out of Japan. You know, they call it the 0.3 or some bullshit. I fucking forgot the name. That are ultra thin, almost like they're not there. Obviously, you can't compare it to not having a condom. But again, condom technology these days, may mga high end. I think galing sa Japan na super nipis sa mga condom na.
Listen,
go back to what I'm saying. If it's for your girlfriend and not for like a regular group of people you're having sex with, birth control pill, you'll be fine.
Yeah, kasi na-open lang yung topic namin ito kasi may wife na ako ngayon. So actually, yung nangyari to, yung paggamit ko ng condoms when yung may girlfriend pa lang ako. So na-open ko lang yung topic sa wife ko ngayon about that. So sabi ko gano'n na, sabi ko parang, ano eh, iba pa rin yung talagang walang condom.
And yeah, to be honest, maski ang girls, mas gusto nilang walang condom.
Yes.
Kasi mas
right, because imagine, imagine if you get rubber and you rub it across your skin over and over and over, you're gonna get pissed off.
Kasi ibang girls na iirita, di ba?
Yes. Oh,
that's right. All right, John, thanks for the call. We appreciate it. Too much mic time for you now. You're 8 minutes into this phone call. Let's now finally talk to Joshua, who's 25. Joshua, you're in Quezon City. You have a question also. What's going on, buddy? Thanks for being here. Josh?
What line? What
sorry.
Line is Josh?
Sorry, line two.
Line two. Hello, Josh.
Josh, what's up?
Hello?
What's up, Josh?
How can we help you? Josh?
Yes, hello?
Yes, you. What's up? How can we help?
About my story.
Well, tell your fucking story. We're waiting.
Ano
nangyari? Let's go.
Huwag mo nang paggalitan. Oh. Bakit kinakabahan? Ano yun, Joshua? Sige.
Yes, kasi it started on September 2. And then...
I don't want to hear this.
September, this tapos October, then
go.
November.
Josh, we don't care the fucking dates. Let's go. What happened?
Something happened.
Wow. Oh, suspense.
Yes. This is just... This is unique. Where's the scriptwriter, John? Can you go ahead and get him a job over there at ABS?
Tinatarantan mo kasi. Maybe
Josh.
He's
okay,
nervous.
Josh, okay, okay. I'll be nice. Okay. Josh?
Yes.
Ano nangyari sa titi mo?
Something happened. We just talked.
Who's we?
No. We, yes. So Facebook
yeah, who's that?
Message. Then something happened. We met. Then yun. And then,
okay, we're going to hang up on you, Josh, for stupidity purposes. Buddy, listen, I gave you a chance. John Lapus there was telling me, hey, Mo, bigyan mo naman ng chance na kinakabahan. But really, John, do you still want to go on with this phone call?
Pwede Mo,
na, pwede na i-disconnect, ha? Do I have your
blessings? Ano ba kasi problema? I don't see the problem. So nag-sex daw sila, tapos, nung we, sabi niya, di ba, we? Oh, di, then nag-sex kayo, congratulations! Job well done!
Yes, and then...
Okay, we're done. We're done. We're done. Hey, listen, I gotta cut in and cut you off. Let's go line three and talk to Jam, who's 27 in Valenzuela. Jam, you're on the show. John Lapus here. Dr. Ken, myself. Welcome back as season two of the podcast is
hello,
is what you're listening
Mo.
To. What's up, buddy?
Yeah, this is regarding my problem with my partner.
Sure, go.
Bali, 1 year na kami. And then, bali kasi para siyang long-distance relationship. Eh. I'm from the north side. Tapos siya. Down south from Laguna, and then she's working, and then I'm working too. Bali, minsan hindi kami nagkikita. Pero may regarding sex life or sex life. Bali, sometimes para masatisfy yung needs ng bawat isa. Then kahit wal hindi physically, we do SOP.
Sure.
Yeah, and then. Minsan kasi parang, di ba, like, yung gusto kong malaman kung paano ma-acquire yung, or paano yung makakuha yung safe and satisfied sex.
With SOPing?
Yeah, kasi minsan kasi parang, importante ba yung, like, with your partner, parang, yung fake orgasm.
Well, how often, okay, wait, let me ask you, how often do you see her? Kung nasa Laguna siya, tapos nasa Valenzuela ka, how often do you guys see each other physically?
3 days a week. Pero minsan, and once lang.
And you don't have sex in those 3 days?
Yeah, meron naman. Pero, syempre, minsan dadating yung time na, parang,
You want to have sex 5 times a day? 5 times a week?
Hindi naman. Parang, yung minsan yung ginagawa namin yun, SOP. So
what's the question?
Paano ba, like, importante ba yung, like, yung fake orgasm? Kasi minsan kasi, eh, pinifake ko siya, and then sometimes nahuli ko din siya. Para lang, isa man lang sa amin, masatisfied.
Eh, kasi, ngayon na lang ulit ako nakarinig, pangalan nito?
Jam?
sa ngayon na ako nakarinig na nag-SOP pa sa panahon ngayon, ang Facebook meron ng webcam.
Yeah, pero minsan kasi siyempre iba yung sked kasi namin eh. Minsan yung pag dumating na siya, ilang oras na lang. So, kaya usually hindi na kami nakapag-online. Through phone na lang kami.
Naku, mag-online kayo kahit sandali lang, magkulo kayo sa banyo.
Sige, ganito. Gusto ko malaman kung gano'ng kakagaling ka sa SOP. So, John, if you can play the girlfriend and then jam, because we need to critique, no? Yung
sige,
mga
sige.
Skills mo sa pagiging SOP boyfriend.
Gusto ko yan,
no?
gusto ko yan.
So, John, give me your girl voice. Tapos, I want to see your skill level kasi it really is on how quote-unquote galing you are on the phone kung magfa-fake siya ng orgasm or kung may totoong orgasm
correct.
Talaga siya.
At saka so, usually, Mo, di ba yung lalaki nagko-control pag sa SOPs?
That's right.
Diba?
Parang dance. It's like a slow dance. Okay, so Jam, pretend that John Lapus is your girlfriend and I want to hear what you bring to the table in terms of SOP. Go.
Hello, Jam. Oh,
John, flirt with him a little bit.
Hi, Jam, baby. How are you? I miss you.
Hi, babe. How are you?
Okay lang. Ito, nakahiga na sa bed.
I miss you, baby.
I miss you too, lang bongga.
Can we do it?
What?
Ano suot mo?
Naka-nighty lang.
Hindi ka ba pagod?
Hindi naman. Hindi nga ako makatulog eh.
Pwede ba natin gawin, baby? Alam mo na.
Sige. Ikaw bahala.
Yeah, I'm just wearing boxer.
Okay.
Tapos,
anong kulay ng boxers mo?
Ano siya eh? Green?
Ayan yung bigay ko sa'yo.
Yeah.
Yeah, bigay ko sa'yo yan. Suot mo rin yan kahapon, ha? Ikaw talaga. Hindi ka pa naliligo.
Hindi mo kasi ako binili ng 2-in-1 eh. Yung reversible.
Oo nga eh. Oh, anyway, yeah. Ako eto, ayan. Naka-nighty, nakahiga lang ako.
My God. Baby. Pwede mo bang, alam mo na.
Ano? Hindi ko alam. Ano?
Yung ano natin, yung lumbingan natin.
Ito na nga. Hawakan ko na ba?
Huwag mo, masyado akong mabilis, baby.
Kasi, hindi ko alam. Puro ka alam mo na, hindi ko nga alam. O, anong gagawin ko?
Basta galingan mo, baby, ha? Yeah. I'm ready.
Okay, let me cut in. Yeah, Jam, you're fucking horrible at this. There are no details. There are no specifics of what you want to happen.
Yeah.
Like John said, sinasabi mo na, alam mo na. I mean, you're really putting the ball in her
turuan
court.
Turuan mo nga, Mo.
Instead of you, instead of you taking control, your mom is there?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you had no problem saying SOP at alam mo naman kailangan naman needs gusto kong, you know, you didn't have a problem telling the story.
Mm-hmm.
Jam, you're horrible at this. You need details. You need to take control. You need to go, babe, I don't want to do this with John because I'm going to feel disgusting, but you really need to be specific about what you want if you want to be great at SOP. Now, John Lapus brought up a great point earlier today was, you know, try different technology. Skype is out there. So at least when you show the boxers na green, na sinuot mo na dalawang araw na, she can actually visually see that. Then she can see your boner through the boxers. Then you pull it down and there's like some sort of reveal, you know, like a showcase in a game show.
And both of you cannot fake the orgasm because you have to show it on camera. Di ba ganun yun?
Mm-hmm.
That's right. You have to show it in camera. Okay, so use Skype and make sure you take advantage of this where you can actually see each other and play with it a little bit more.
Mm. Yeah. I have one question again.
Go, quickly.
Kasi yung, like yung job interview or the BJ part, hindi niya kasi na-satisfied yung need. Parang hindi todo. And then this one thing na ano, ito, secret lang to ha. Baka malaman niya. Meron akong hot encounter sa bar and I got tipsy. Oh. And then after, go to the contract room and then yung encounter is the same same sex.
So you had a gay experience.
Ah, bakla! Binlochab ka ng bakla!
Yeah, medyo tipsy na ako nun.
din. Nasarap pang kawag ka ng...
Yeah.
Well, let me ask this.
Okay, time out. Okay, thanks for the call. We're going to have to hang up on you because it's been here a while now. But I need to ask John this question, John.
What?
Why do I hear so many stories of this happening? Kasi, for example, di ba nag-inuman tayo nung bago ko umalis, di ba? Mm. John and I went out drinking. John Lapus, how many shots of tequila did you have that night?
Oh my God.
16?
17? 18? Oh, pero yung 18, isang bote na yun.
No. You ordered 16 shots of tequila. Okay, you and I, we went out drinking.
Oh.
So I was drunk. John was drunk. And even though medyo malambing ka dyan, nakita yata pa natin si Masiya rin pa pumasok sa bar. Tapos si John pa sabi, itong friend ko, si Mo. You know, gumaganyan-ganyan pa sa akin. But I would know at that moment, even if I was drunk,
mm-mm,
that you will not be allowed to give me a blowjob. Like, there's, like, I don't understand why there are a lot of guys out there na tumatawag sa show na to, tumatawag din sa radio show, sinasabi nila, mm-mm, alam mo, lasing ako, tapos may nakita ko na laki, tapos blowjob ako, eh, syempre, lasing ako.
Parang, oh, sus! Gusto rin nila yun!
We hear this story all the time. So ano to? A, bakla sila din, but, you know, they're just hiding it. Or B, hindi talaga nalalaman ano ginagawa nila habang lasing.
No. Feeling ko yan, kung straight talaga yung lalaki, nag-ilang siyang horny because of the alcohol. And a free blowjob would do, di ba? Walang masama. Or usually, yung lalaki, bitin pa sa alak, gusto pang uminom, wala ng pera, nakakita ng bakla sa bar. So nagpa-blowjob na para bayaran ng bakla yung next round. Ganun yun?
And that happens all the time.
Oo naman. Ang ganda ng mga bakla ngayon. Ano? Ako lang, minsan nilalapitan akong kusa. Ano? Ako na yung tumatanggi sa lalaki ngayon.
So yan yung style, halimbawa na sa bar ka. You can't afford all the drinks that you had. May nakita kang bakla, sige, oh, paano, pa-blowjob naman. And then, babayarin niya yung drinks?
Oh, may ganun lalaki. Medyo mga lalaki makakabalang mukha. Sabi ko sa'yo, may iba mga lalaki nga ngayon, mamamakla ngayon, pero kasi kailangan niya ng pera dahil the next day, mambababae naman siya.
Pwede?
Or, ano siya, bisexual or ginagamit lang para sa pera?
Alam mo, matagal ng argument yan eh. Because sa mga lalaki, di ba, sex is sex. So, hindi po kaya isang lalaki nakipag-sex na sa kapwa lalaki, pwede mo na siyang tawaging bakla. Okay.
Oh.
So,
I don't agree. I think the moment you're a guy and you get another guy to give you a blowjob, you're gay.
So, I have to disagree with that and I have to agree with John.
Mo, syempre,
hindi nga ganun.
Ang Pilipinas, third world country, may mga lalaki na yun ang trabaho, di ba?
Tama si John.
So, trabaho lang nila yun. So, kailangan nilang gawin yun. Kailangan nilang i-satisfy yung bakla. Kailangan nilang ipasubo yung nota nila doon sa bakla. Kasi yun ang trabaho nila.
I would rather, as a straight guy, I would rather deal drugs than, and no, this is no offense, John, to your orientation, but I would rather deal drugs than give blowjobs for money as a straight guy.
Oy, pero dati sinabi mo pa binigyan ka ng 1 million, di ba? Magpapablowjob ka sa bakla.
Not 1 million. Huh? Yeah, not 1 million. Like 75 million or 50 million.
Precisely I mean, my point.
That's a lot of money.
75 right. million, nagpa-blowjob ka sa bakla.
And then I'm gay, but I'm 75 million pesos richer.
Of course not. Nagpa-blowjob ka because of the 75 million, not because you're gay.
I don't agree. All right, let's take a commercial break. We're going to take our first break of the program. It is Good Times with Mo, the podcast, Season 2, Episode 1. John Lapus, our guest today.
Uh-huh.
Tomorrow, we'll have Mocha. Wednesday, Erwan Husaf. Also, on Thursday, we have Denise Laurel. Friday, Dr. Hayden Koh on the program. Dr. Ken is here, by the way. Ken, you're doing a great job, man. I'm impressed. You're coming out pretty natural.
Oh, magaling. All
right. All right. I have some information to give you guys also about how to be part of the relief effort for victims of Typhoon Pablo, especially it being Christmas time. I'll tell you more about that when we return from the commercial break. Don't go away. It's Good Times with the podcast back after this.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
I have a new girl who lets me do what I love. She updates me on new star athletes to watch for and the teams that are just killing it. She helps me plan which games to catch with the guys, or the next marathon we can join. She teaches me how to condition myself for sports, which cool music to work out to, and where I can go on my next adventure. A girl who loves what I love. She's Christine, my digital go-to girl. Log on to Christine.com and get more out of what you love. Also available on iOS and Android.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us
us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast and visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the show here on a Monday night, you're listening to Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Of course, it's season two as we bring back this wonderful show. Our guest tonight is John Lapus. We also have Dr. Ken here. Before we get back to your phone calls at 478-7954, I want to remind everyone, it is Christmas time and a time to help country. You know, every now and then we get hit by these calamities and shit. Let the Pablo victims feel that it's Christmas time. You can donate money to them, relief efforts, via GCash. So just text donate, space your amount, and type in Pablo. Send it to 2882 if you are on Globe. And speaking of Globe, we are giving away a iPhone 5, a Globe iPhone 5 on the show. You can win it. Hopefully tonight, if you're caller of the night and you choose the iPhone correctly, that phone is yours. It comes with a one-year, 2,500 monthly plan for free. One whole year, absolutely no charge. That is for you, for being a listener and a follower and a subscriber of this podcast. All right, let's get to more of your phone calls. Again, phone number is 478-7954, John Lapus and Dr. Ken. John, you are you're a good friend of mine, man.
Yes! And, I miss you, by the way. I miss you so much.
I remember before I left the Philippines, and I was going through all of this horrible shit, and you saw how destroyed I was, right? I mean, that's why we haven't had a podcast for a year, is because there was this recovery process for me. And I'm glad you stuck around, and you're still my friend and stuff like that. I mean, you were there, like, you know, weeks before I was leaving. You would always call me. You check on me. You bring me food. Did I really look like shit back then?
Yeah, and for me to do that, it's the fact that I could feel it. I could see how depressed you were at that time. So that's why now, diba, when you were in New York, I've been asking you, have you been eating? And I remember the last time na nagpunta ako doon sa bahay mo dyan sa Makati to guest in your podcast, I asked your yaya sa kitchen if you've been eating, di ka nga daw kumakain, even your mom is getting worried na nga daw. So doon ako, okay, so no wonder it's getting thinner and thinner that time. Super payat mo kaya that time before yung kaumayas?
Yeah, it was wild. So, but thank you for being there.
Welcome.
I appreciate
you
that. I want to make sure that I say that on air because I appreciate it wholeheartedly.
Wala yun. If there's one person who would understand the situation that you were in that time, that is me. Because you're in a different way though. There's more or less some kind of like that happened to me in the past na ikaw din nakakaalam amongst few people.
That's right. Yeah. All right, so here we go. Back to the phone calls. 478-7954. Let's take line number three. His name's Adam. He's 23 from Pasig. Adam, you've been on the hold for an hour, 10 minutes, or some crazy amount of time. So thanks for being there, buddy. What's going on, Adam? Line three.
Welcome back, Mo.
Thanks, man. It's nice to be back. Merry Christmas. What's up?
Yeah, Merry Christmas, yeah. I know, Mo. My mom passed away. It's a bit sad. My mom passed away last July, and this is the first Christmas that I was spent without her.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so I have tips kung paano mag-celebrate ng darating holidays without
being How did your mom pass away? Like, what happened to her?
Aneurysm.
Oh, fuck, man. The aneurysm sucks, dog.
Aneurysm, so biglaan.
Yeah, that comes out of nowhere.
Magkasama kami nung gabi, then umuwi ako, then yun, 1, 2 a.m. yun.
Doc, before we get to the rest of your call, Adam, Doc, when a person has an aneurysm, how quick is it from aneurysm to imminent death, or maybe not imminent because you could save, but what's the time frame? Like, how many minutes do you have before the person just dies?
Okay, I understand. First of all, an aneurysm is like a vessel that's like very weak. And it forms, it can explode. So it can become a ruptured aneurysm. So when it ruptures, you're going to bleed all over your brain and
you're dead.
Yeah. In like a minute, when you lose that blood supply to your brain, then you could die.
So if to survive an aneurysm, you have to have an aneurysm in the hospital next to a doctor. Fucking probably, you know, in the emergency room or in your kind of surgical
Even
room
so,
or whatever
even
it may be,
so,
I mean.
if you are in a hospital and it ruptures there and you identify that it ruptured, even if you are in a hospital, wala ka na rin magagawa. So the key thing is to identify it before it ruptures. Usually patients would complain of severe headache.
Yun na.
And then you get a scan.
MRI na kaagad yun dapat.
Actually, an angiogram.
Angiogram.
Correct. So MRA or an angiogram. Yeah.
Para makita kung may
correct. No, okay, yeah. So, and then if you see it, right? Say you see the aneurysm. Yes. What do? They cut your head open and they fucking fix it?
Correct. They clip it.
Jesus.
Oh, so you go to a neurosurgeon and they operate on you. They open your head.
Soon
and
yon.
Then they clip it because if you clip the aneurysm, then, you know, even if it explodes, then the blood supply won't, like, spill over. Kiniklip mo yung ano eh.
Kaya pala ngayon, alam ba sa mga ospital, pag severe migraine, automatic, ano ka na?
I would agree.
Angiogram or MRI.
MRI.
Pinapapasok sa ganun.
MRI.
O yun, kaya pala, para sigurado na.
Tama yan.
Ano po yung usually ang cause? Para, kasi yung mga namamatay, parang nga, ano nangyari? Bigla ano ang cause? Na.
You are born with an inherent weakness of these vessels.
Oh.
So you might ask a history of aneurysm
in the family. May correct. Chance.
And ang aneurysm hindi lang sa ano ah, hindi lang sa brain. Ano?
Saan pa?
Pwede ka rin magkaroon ng aneurysm sa abdomen. Because there are big blood vessels there. So aortic aneurysm, the big vessel that comes out of your heart and goes to the abdomen to supply all your organs, can also have a weakness on its wall. And it can rupture and you can die in a minute.
Sa tiyan naman yun, sasakit
sa tiyan naman yun. Sa sakit tiyan mo, kumakain ka lang, and then biglang, pow, you're dead.
And that's fatal.
It is. Absolutely.
Just as fast.
You'll die of exsanguination or blood loss.
Uy, condolence. Anong pangalan ng caller?
Hey, listen, this is too fucking, his name's Adam. This is too depressing. All right, Adam, so what's the question, man? You said you want tips on how to survive this Christmas season without your mom?
Yeah.
You know, we all cope differently when we lose someone, man. Some people go to church. I mean, I don't believe in that shit anymore. Like, I think it's fucking horse crap. Like,
sobra ka naman, nakakaloka naman.
No, really.
Yeah, but that's his opinion.
I was listening to the old podcast, and you know, after the whole, you know, the baby incident and stuff that happened in my life, and I remember just praying that God, please, you know, change the mind, change her mind. You know, we got to say, and then it didn't work. So after that, I lost hope in this. I'm like, you know, this sucks, man. I'm not going to believe in Jesus and in organized religion anymore because these people are evil. I mean, that's what I was thinking. So I've turned away from that. And now that my dad is sick and my dad is, you know, quote unquote dying right now, I don't pray for him. I just try to spend as much time possible. I don't know what's going to happen when he passes away. I'm going to have to ask myself, what am I going to do to cope with the loss? It's tough. It depends on what kind of person you are. Like, are you a religious person? Are you the type who's very close to your siblings? Maybe you want to organize some sort of, like a family reunion or something like that, so everybody can have each other for the first time, or for the first Christmas without her. You know, you can either be proactive, or you can be spiritual about it.
Maganda yon, ano, surround yourself with people that you love or people that loves you. So, para sa darating na Pasko, di ba, you have to, maaalala mo lang, you know, na, that you are loved and yung maaalala mo, isipin mo lang yung good memories mo kasama ang nanay mo. And I'm pretty sure kasi pag nagiging malungkot sa darating na Pasko, wherever she is, she will be very sad as well. So, yun na lang isipin mo na, maski ngayon wala na siya sa piling mo, she still binabantayan ka pa rin niya palagi. Yun lang yun.
Yeah, I have to agree with John and Mo that every person has a different way of coping. But I'd like to tell Adam, okay lang maging malungkot sa Pasko. It's okay. Because somebody you love just passed away. So don't worry about...
It's normal.
Yeah, it's normal. Huwag ka masyado ma-pressure na, uy, kailangan masaya pag Pasko. Eh, hindi ganun eh.
Hindi, tsaka totoo yan. Ako, alam ni Mo yan, pag nade-depress ako, talagang nade-depress ako, nagbabaliw-baliwan ako, naglolokalokahan ako. But by doing that, in a way, nare-release mo yung kabaliwan mo, yung lungkot mo.
That's
and
right.
From then, you could move, from there, makakapag-move on ka na.
That's a humane way of coping.
Correct. Yeah.
At tsaka next
Adam,
year, hindi naman ganun.
Loss.
It's not gonna be like that next year.
We're sorry for your loss, Adam, and thanks for calling in. I hope we helped out a little bit. I guess surround yourself with family, man. If it's a family member like that died tragically, get your siblings together, your titas, your uncles, you know, your dad, whatever, and have a big Christmas with everyone. And hopefully, you guys, it'll be a pivotal move on point from there. Okay.
Yeah. Also, Mo. Thank you.
All right, buddy. Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Hello, Mo.
Yeah, Merry Christmas, man. Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you for the gift check of Restan Fresh, yeah.
Oh, I gave you? Oh, okay, good. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I like giving shit away. So, all right. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Let's see here. Mark has been on line one. He's been on hold a long time.
May kaibigan ako pag nalulungkot, nakikipag-sex. Very effective.
We haven't had a...
Yes. Nagre-release daw yung utak ng endorphins, yung
correct.
Happy glands.
Yeah, tama.
Maka-effective din yun, Adam.
When you get laid... Before your orgasm, you release all your anxiety. Otherwise, right. You won't orgasm. And when you release your anxiety...
Yeah, but it's temporary. Because when I was depressed and I would have sex with someone, it'd be like... it's 80% of the time, I don't even want to have sex with that person just because, you know, it's just... You're depressed.
Yeah,
you're sad.
It is temporary, it's but it's also important.
Temporary, but kahit pa paano, at that very moment, naibisan yung lungkot mo.
Yeah, okay, it's two minutes of pleasure.
Oh, edi makipag-sex ka ng 24 hours, di tapos.
Listen, I got 2 minutes. All right, Justine, you're 22. Let's talk to a female. We haven't had a female yet. Justine, 22, you're from Santa Mesa. What's up? Line 2. Justine? Justine,
hello,
on line
Justine.
2.
Yeah,
I think
you're not.
Justine.
Yeah, what's up, baby?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hi, I have a love and sex problem. I think a mix of both.
Okay, tell a story. What's going on?
Okay, so I've been dating this guy for 3 years already. And then last month, he got a big problem that caused us to break. I caught him looking for sexual thing outside the relationship, and he used Craigslist to do that. He inquired from a lot of girls who are exchanging that for money, and then I confronted him about it. He admitted it, and he said sorry, and he said it's just really out of curiosity. I forgave him and everything, but then weeks after, I found out that one or two of the girls replied back to him, and he gave out his cell phone number. And then weeks later, I found out that he's meeting up some girls, or a girl, this particular girl. I'm not sure if that's the girl from Craigslist or what. But then I asked him if why is he doing that to me and everything. He's really sorry. He said that he's not able
Justine,
to get...
Justine, no, he's not really sorry. Justine, he's not really sorry. If he was really sorry, it would have ended after you caught him the first time giving out his number on Craigslist.
Correct.
That's sorry. Listen, okay, when he meets up with them, Justine, listen to me, baby. You're 22, okay. I'm 35. I know this shit, right? And Ken here, my age, John, a little older than me. We're all on the same page. I can feel it. When he meets up with girls from Craigslist and they're talking about boning each other, do you know what they're doing when they meet up? Justine, they're boning each other. Yes. So your boyfriend is having sex with strangers off the internet. He's putting his dick in that pussy. Then he's going to remove it and put it on you.
Oh, my God.
That is true.
Yeah, okay. I actually had a really heart-to-heart conversation. For me, I mean, I'm a strong girl. He knows that. I can just leave him and get over it and just like a flick of the hand. But then he started crying.
His dick was crying on some girl's body.
And everything. Yes?
Justine, his penis was crying semen on someone else weeks prior. So what if he's crying?
He's crying because he said that he can't live without me, that he won't find another girl like me and everything. And that, but I told him that I was really hurt. And that conversation happened after knowing that he returned the
All right, Justine, how about this? Okay, you're 22, right? You're 22. This is the hottest you'll ever be in your life, okay? And you're tolerating this guy who's fucking strangers on Craigslist. Okay, is he super rich?
What?
Is he really wealthy? Is he super rich guy? Your boyfriend?
Yeah, he used to be with girls before, and he did it all the time. Well, actually, I have to admit that I haven't been really up for it. I'm not. We make out sometimes.
Justine, it doesn't matter. Listen, maybe he wants to have sex because his girlfriend doesn't want to have sex, but he knows what kind of relationship he's in. He's in a relationship with someone who wants to save herself, who's not, you know, very sexual right now because you guys are not married or whatever the reason may be. And that's part of the deal. That's the way it is.
Are you in love with this guy?
Just because you don't have sex doesn't.
Second boyfriend.
It's pretty obvious,
Justine,
that
it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Justine, 22 ka pa lang. You're young, and sa boses mo, I assume you're pretty. Marami pa ng lalaki ang huhumaling sa'yo. Yung lalaki na hindi man bababae habang girlfriend mo siya at aantayin ang time na gusto mo na makipag-sex sa kanya. Okay.
Yeah, but I have one question though. Is it like for every man? Is it the need for doing that?
Men are naturally polygamous. Aminin mo yan, Mo Twister.
No, it's not polygamous. How about this? Men are just generally they're horny. And the thing is, these guys they can masturbate if you're not having sex. Maybe he's not ready for a relationship. Obviously, he's not ready for a relationship because he wants a lot of sex. And Justine, if you have decided to not give that, that is an extremely, like, personal decision that you've made. And it doesn't mean that he can go out and bang girls off the internet.
Yeah, that's right.
Listen to Mo, Justine.
Justine, you can't tolerate this
shit.
That's
all I can say.
Oh.
Now, is it any different if you walked in the room and and he was having sex with a girl in front of your face? Would you then break up with him?
Yeah.
Ooh, wala naman difference
yun. Anyway, you're just not walking in the room.
Yeah, she's
the same thing.
She's still hoping that they'll fix it because she's in love with this.
Hindi, at saka feeling ko itong si Justine nung iniyakan siya, doon siya naapektuhan eh.
Yeah, exactly.
No, and this is what happened. Yeah, this is what happened. It was
me, and he said,
I don't give a fuck, Justine. So what? Oh my! If that's what it takes, if that's what it takes to get forgiven,
that's why I'm curious. Maybe, yeah, I don't know.
Maybe you feel guilty, Justine, that you're not giving him sex, and you're like, okay, well, I understand, kasi may mga needs ka, kasi. That's what guys would use. They'll use that excuse. Kasi alam mo naman, babe, ako laki ako, may mga needs kami. Tapos alam ko, I respect na ayaw mo mag-sex yet until we're married. I respect that. But syempre, may mga needs din ako. And then you're like, oh, nga no. No! You can't let that happen.
Oh, yeah, that's right. The next time I'm gonna do, after I call you guys, I'm gonna really end this relationship.
Yay!
End this relationship tonight.
That's the only sign I want. Like, I want to hear it from someone who's really experienced. Like,
good luck.
Yes.
Justine,
break up with this motherfucker.
But I don't believe you. You're not gonna break up with this guy.
Good point, Doc. You're fucking lying to us, but fine. Yes, try to break up with him tonight.
Kaya mo yan, Justine. Tas labas tayo. Marami kong papakilala sa'yo.
I'm really sure about it.
All right, you got to break up. You got to break up with this guy. All right, you want to break up on air? You want to do it on the show?
Oh, ngayon na gusto mo? Baka nakikinig yon.
Let's break up on the program. Yes, Justine.
I told you, Mo.
Justine, you want? Can we put you on hold and call your asshole boyfriend and break up with him on air?
Okay. Thanks, guys.
What?
I can't now.
I will. Thank you, guys. For giving me a really good talk about it.
Thanks for the call. Alex, you're 21 on line 4. You're from Caloocan. I believe this is a female Alex. And she has a question about her boyfriend as well. Alex, line 4? No? She was on a cell phone. Let's talk to RJ, who's 20 on line 1. He's from Rizal. He has a medical question for the doc. RJ, good evening. Welcome to the program. You have a question for Ken here.
Hey, RJ.
Hello.
Go ahead.
Sir, ano pong epekto ng gonorrhea sa male?
Naku.
Sa male.
Patay.
Pares din ang effect sa babae at saka sa lalaki, no? Pero if you're asking about the symptoms, masakit siya, mahapdi siya, you're gonna have a lot of discharge from your penis. It's not gonna look good, it's not gonna smell good. And
Ano siya,
it's really easy to treat it, by the way, RJ.
Yeah,
it only takes one
round of antibiotics, and you're good.
One injection. One gram of this injection, ceftriaxone and stuff like that. So, the most important thing is avoid it.
Wait. It's easy. I think the problem with gonorrhea is it had such a notorious reputation in the past.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like tuberculosis, right? When you tell someone, oh, may TB ka, ay putang ina mamamatay ka. No, it's completely curable now. Everybody fucking relax, you know?
That's right.
Gonorrhea is the same thing. It had a huge history, a huge resume of being horrible, but now completely curable. What are some of the STDs or STIs out there that will really, that are really scary these days? Obviously, the HIV is going to always be there until they find a cure for that shit.
There you go. Syphilis?
What are some of the ones? Oh.
Syphilis?
Syphilis. That's been around for a long time, huh?
Yeah.
But you can do a round of antibiotics and get rid of syphilis as well, right?
Correct. Yeah. But the thing is, if you're talking about venereal diseases or sexually transmitted diseases, like what I mentioned earlier, you could cure it. But for example, in my specialty, if it goes to your eye, bulag ka pare. You can get blind from that. And that is irreversible. You can only do a corneal transplant.
Have you seen someone get blind because of sex?
Well, because of the venereal disease, yes. If they're going to dive and going to do... absolutely, Mo. Absolutely.
How do they come to your office and go, Doc, tinira ko sa mata eh, putang ina, boyfriend ko. Tapos, and then all of a sudden, bulag na sila?
Well, they come there and they complain of severe discharge and eye redness. Yeah. And then what we do...
And you know that's jizz.
We look at it in sperm. The microscope. We examine it.
And you see little sperm running.
We know. Not really sperm. But we see the cornea melting. We recognize the pattern. And then what we do to definitely diagnose it, we get a sample, we look at it in the microscope, and we see Neisseria gonorrhea. No, the microorganism.
Gonorrhea, hindi yung sperm.
Gram-negative diplococci.
Oh.
All right, John, you're very good friends with Chris Aquino. No, what sexual transmitted disease did Chris Aquino have?
Ay, hindi ko alam. I was really surprised when she admitted it during that interview, di ba? Yung sila ni Joey Marquez yata yun eh.
I really have no idea.
And lahat kami ng mga fans, we were surprised nung sinabi niya yun on Philippine television. And after nun, we didn't bother to ask her again or follow
really?
Up.
John, if I had an STD, you would fucking ask me right away. And you're closer to Chris than I am. Why didn't you ask Chris what she had?
Bilang lalaki ka naman. Ay, babae naman yun. Ano ka ba? Tsaka, during that time, yung circumstances din mo, di ba, she's really having a very difficult time. Galing sila sa breakup. May issue sila na nag-away sila ni Joey. So, it is really something na, nung time na yun, puro family members lang basically yung kasama niya. Medyo umiwas siya sa mga tao, sa mga fans, di ba? So...
Gotcha.
Iba yung circumstances eh. Tsaka yun, siguro the fact na din yung sitwasyon niya na yun. Pero kung ikaw lang kasi,
okay naman yung
tatanungin
niya,
talaga so kita kasi alam ko, pag nagkaroon ka ng gonorrhea dahil sa katangahan mo or kalibugan mo, kaya, may gonorrhea ka daw, kaswal lang, di ba?
Gotcha. All right, RJ, thanks for the call. We appreciate it. Let's go to Mark, who's 16 years old, on line 2. Mark is from Caloocan, and let's see what he has for the show today. Mark, welcome to the podcast.
Hello,
Season 2, Episode 1 with John Lapus and Ken.
Hello.
What's your question?
Ano po kasi ganito? Yung paano po bang pwedeng gawin ko po? Kasi po, para pong lumabas na naging paasa ako sa 20 years old na babae. Pero hindi ko naman po siya pinaasa.
Huh?
Opo.
You're 16 po, and there's a girl out there na 20 years old na
mas matanda po.
I mean,
na pinapaasa niya.
Ano ibig sabihin nun? Like yung parang she says that you have a future together with her pero wala talaga nangyayari?
Opo. Hindi, kasi po.
And what's your question?
16.
Nagkakilala po kami sa online game po. Para pong nagkagusto po siya sa akin, ganun.
Tapos what did she say?
Po,
like,
ayun, parang ngayon po, galit po siya sa akin.
Ah, kasi nakikipag-break ka na.
Hindi naman po kami naging.
Ah?
Parang, ayun po.
Okay, what's the question? I'm fucking
bored.
Galit po siya sa akin.
Eh, no, ngayon, kung galit siya sa'yo.
Oo, hindi naman pala kayo, hayaan mo, hindi magalit siya.
Diba?
Ayun nga po eh. ayoko pong may nagagalit po sa akin.
I understand.
So what's the question?
Paano po bang ano? Paano po, ano pong pwedeng gawin ko para po mapatawad niya ako?
Para di siya magalit sa'yo.
Hmm.
Mark, listen, you're 16, she's 20. You guys are not going to get in a relationship. I mean, you guys met on a fucking video game. This is going nowhere. You know, you understand this, right? Yeah. Because she's going to be 21, 22, and you're still a fucking teenager. Mm-hmm. This is not going anywhere.
Yeah. Alam mo, Mark, iwasan mo na lang siya dahil bilang 16 years old ka pa lang, siya ay 20 na. Under the law, ikaw minor de edad pa. Baka pag nalaman pa yan ng mga magulang mo, idemanda pa ang babae niya ng statutory rape.
Hindi naman po sa ganun.
Ha?
Hindi naman po sa ganun.
Eh, yun ang nga sinasabi ko.
Ganito po kasi.
Oh.
Yung babae po na yun, sikat, medyo sikat po siya sa Facebook, ganyan.
Oh.
Tapos, ako po, pag ganun po, syempre marami.
No. Yun, you said the magic word. Mark, you said the magic word. Kung sikat siya sa Facebook, there's no way she's dating you, a 16-year-old fucking retard here. There's no way that this girl's gonna date you. She's just sikat siya sa Facebook because she's pretty. Maybe she flirts with a lot of people online, and you're just one of those guys that thinks she likes you. She doesn't like you.
Hindi naman po. Mabait naman po siya.
Yes, it's true. No. Mark, I've seen these a lot all the time. There are hot chicks out there that go online. They amass a huge following because there are a lot of horny boys that play video games like you who sees this super hot chick and you're like, oh, wow, I'm going to flirt. This girl acknowledges your existence, which she shouldn't be because she's hot. And then you all of a sudden think that she likes you. She doesn't like you. She's 20 and she's popular.
Tapos,
you're 16 playing video games.
Correct. Tapos to reverse the situation, sinasabi niya na pinaasa mo siya, pero ang totoo, dinadump ka na niya. May ganun pala.
She's just fucking with your mind.
Napakalanding babae.
There's no reason a 20-year-old would date
you. Umiwas ka na sa kanyang babae. 16 ka pa lang, malandi yan.
Ako rin po siguro kasi may kasalanan. Kasi po, parang... Ayun nga, lumabas na paasa ako. Hindi ko naman
siya pinasa. No.
Nahulog po
no,
siya
Mark,
sa akin.
You are living in a video game world. This is not happening. You just think it's happening. It's fantasy. This girl does not like you. There's no reason for her to like you. She's popular. She's 20. She catches a Facebook. You are at home playing video games. She flirts with you one time and you think she wants your dick. No.
Sinasabi lang niya yon para ikaw yung mag-guilty. Tulad ng nangyayari ngayon, nag-guilty ka at umabot ka na, tumatawag ka na rito sa podcast ni Mo Twister.
Para po kasi,
all right, goodbye, Mark.
Naging mag-MU
Mark.
Rin po kami.
Naku!
No, you're not. Really? What did you do? What have you done na MU? Do you go out together every weekend?
Ganun.
Yeah,
po, like, po
what makes it MU?
Parang hindi po ako handa naligawan siya.
Mark,
ito,
you're so
gusto ko po
full of
makatapos
shit.
Mo ng pag-aaral kasi
Sera, 16, po, kalibugan mo yan, di ba? Ganong edad, 16?
Gusto niya rin makatapos ng pag-aaral muna.
Mark,
hindi totoo yan.
This is bullshit, Mark. The girl doesn't like you. Please, just study hard.
Pero ano na po siya? Nag-teacher po siya, kakagraduate niya lang po.
Okay, then that's really wrong. Teacher-student relationships, out of the question. Mark, thanks for the call. Appreciate it. Get out of the situation. Forget this girl. Don't worry about it. JR17 on line 3, you are from Makati. You can really tell the difference between teenagers and adults when they call the show, no?
Like,
teenagers
absolutely,
are fucking dumb.
Yeah.
Hindi naman dumb. Mo naman sabihin dumb.
Let's prove it right here. JR, 17 years old. What's going on in your world?
Hello?
Yes, JR.
What's up?
Hello. If I'm having sex with a girl and she didn't have an orgasm, does that make me not good in bed?
See? Didn't I just say teenagers are fucking weirdos, right? JR, no. Because there are a lot of girls out there that don't have orgasms when they have sex. A lot of them. Shit, I might even say 50% of them don't have it with intercourse alone. No. With intercourse alone, I'd say 80% don't have orgasm, especially if you're boning 17-year-olds as well, right? Because they're really not in. They don't really have a true grasp of their orgasming ability. Like some of them, a lot of females only realize they can't orgasm when they're in their early 20s. So it doesn't mean that you're bad in bed, but you have to be aware that when you're having sex with this girl, that you have to do other things to get her to orgasm, and it doesn't involve just putting your dick in her. Oral sex, touching, even a little bit of romance. I mean, all of that kind of contributes to whether she's going to have an orgasm or not. How old is this girl?
For about 20, 21.
She's 20 as well? Is it the same girl from the last guy calling? Because what are these 20-year-olds dating these teenagers for?
Facebook.
Same person.
JR, you have to learn how to... Okay, experience. You have to learn how to give oral sex. That's really the key. That's the best bet. That's the best bet for you to get a girl to orgasm as often as you'd like.
Okay.
JR, may mga diskarte na...
And don't, especially the fingering part, during the fingering part, don't ever treat a vagina like a penis. Because you know when you're with your penis and you're masturbating, you're really aggressive with it, you're like, don't do that to a girl. Don't jam your finger in her. This is fucking awesome. Yeah, don't do that. Okay? Gentle.
Thanks, Mo.
All right? Don't put, maybe see, okay, one finger, okay, two fingers, okay, three fingers, four fingers. You gotta relax. Okay?
Thanks.
All right. Mouth to clitoris. That's the key. Young man. All right, you young Jedi. Thanks for the call. Alex, 21, on line 1 from Caloocan. Sex with your boyfriend has become boring.
Hello?
Yes, Alex, what's up?
You know, I just want to ask kasi, ngayon, nag-work ako. So, ang problem ko, yung boyfriend ko, wala pa din siyang work. So, para ang nangyayari, tuwing magkikita kami, parang same na lang yung nangyayari, parang may nangyayaring sex. Tapos parang pampalipas oras, parang ganun. Parang gusto ko naman parang
how long have you been
magago.
Together? How long have you been together?
3 years.
How long?
3 years.
So you were together when you were 18 with this guy, and you're saying that it's starting to get... How often are you guys still having sex?
Once a month.
Once a week? Once a month. Yeah. Once you know, Alex, this relationship is over. It's time to break up. And I mean, as cruel as that is to hear, I already know from the details. Like, I'm so bored with having sex with him. We have sex only once a month. Imagine you're 21 years old and you're having sex only once a month.
Uh-oh.
And even in that once a month, you're bored. And when sex is such a huge communication tool in a relationship, and... You, at that young age, you guys should be fucking every day. But you're only doing it once a month. And even in that once a month, you're bored. That means this relationship has run its course and it's time to break up. I don't even have to hear about the other qualities. I already know off the bat with the sexual problem that you guys are having. You guys got together when you were 18. This is, you know, you're supposed to be breaking up right now anyway. Even if the sex was great, you should be breaking up right now.
At saka walang trabaho yung lalaki. So ikaw nagbabayad ng motel? Ganun ba yun? Ang pangit naman.
Same question. Same question for you. Why are you with this guy? Do you love him?
Yes. No. Before kasi maging kami. So, best friend talaga kami.
Okay.
Super close as in talaga. Not just na parang naging mag-best friend kami na dahil may gusto kami.
Okay, I know. But this
so happened
when you were teenagers. You guys were friends when you were teenagers. You can still be friends now. What you can't be is a couple because you have already... exhausted the relationship. You know, dude, it's normal. Listen, Alex, you're not supposed to be with this guy. That's what I'm trying to say. Because you're supposed to have 2, 3, 4 relationships at this age. You know, you've been together with him for 3 years. You started off as teenagers dating. It's time to move on already. Once a month, sex at 21 is very odd. You should be doing it more. And again, in that once a month, you're already bored. It, move on from this.
Yeah, that's why I'm trying to find something so parang maging exciting or parang maiba naman.
No. Listen, so you're going to find something. This is what's going to happen. You're going to find something exciting. You're like, sige, babe, try na natin, you know, 69, tapos dog, reverse cowgirl. And it's just going to last for a few weeks. And then after this, you're gonna hate him again. Because this relationship has already run its course. You don't have to hate each other. You don't have to break up badly, but you need to break up, like, period.
Okay.
I know it's hard to hear, but it's really the truth.
Okay, thanks for helping me.
Thanks for nothing? Is that what she said?
No.
No, thanks for listening.
Oh,
yeah.
Sorry. Oh, listening. Sorry, I thought you said thanks for nothing. I'm
okay,
like, oh,
no
yeah,
problem, Alex.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, baby.
Thank you for having me, guys. It's a big help for me.
Good luck.
Okay. Well, you're welcome, baby.
Pagdadasal ko, makapag-move on ka kaagad at makahanap ka ng bagong jowa.
Wait. Alex, are you masturbating a lot?
What?
Are you masturbating a lot?
No.
No. Yeah, you're that unhappy?
I do that often.
That's what I was asking. That means this relationship is done. Okay? You shouldn't be masturbating as often if you have a 21-year-old boyfriend. You guys should be banging.
Okay. Thanks for helping me.
You're welcome. Now go masturbate.
Thanks
make yourself
for loving me daw. Anong reason nun, Doc?
Love yourself.
Mo, anong love reason nun? Pag gano'n, naging boring yung ano.
Well,
yung sex life.
Well, let's hang up on her because the background noise is fucking with me. But it's because they started young. Like, they started at 18. No. So what happens is you're supposed to, like when you're young, you're supposed to have relationships at 1 year, 2 years. After 2-3 years, you start getting bored, especially when you started as a teenager.
Pero pag ganun ka bata, hindi ba minsan importante na parang may variety yung sex? Minsan sa bubong kayo, sa kusina, sa banyo, sa ilalim ng table. Kaya
not necessarily.
I'm sure that's what it used to be.
Not
I'm sure that's what it used to be.
Sa jeep,
no,
sa taxi.
No, because this girl is calling the show and saying, I'm bored. Meaning they
the way
had,
I read
at one
the,
time,
this girl
they
is,
had an exciting sex life.
That is possible, but they lost it.
No, that is what it is, dude.
The
she's
reason why
the show and saying
they lost
she's calling
it.
The show. Look, no, Ken, listen. The reason why she's calling the show is not because they're not having sex enough.
Okay.
It's not because of any. It's because it's boring. That means at one time it was very exciting, and that one time was when they were 18. Now that they're in their early 20s, they're starting to realize that hey, you're boring.
And I think I have an idea why it's becoming boring. First of all, like what John pointed out, this guy doesn't have a job.
Walang trabaho daw, di ba? Yung
so
nasabi niya.
A man is built around his ego, every single gentleman. Pag wala kang trabaho, you lose self-esteem.
Okay, if you're 25,
poorly.
If you're 27, mm-hmm. If you're 30, I get it. Fine, yes, mm-hmm. I agree. Not when you're 18. When you're 18, there's no concept of I'm a man and I need to provide for my girlfriend. At 18? No. At 18, it's let's go to the movies. You can give me a hand job while we're watching and, you know, and I'm eating the popcorn and then I'm going to fuck you in the car after. That's
so she's
what
21
you do
and the guy's 18.
No, that's what they were doing when they were 18. They're
oh,
still
they
21.
18.
He's probably still
21
in school.
Na kaya oh. Nga siguro na bored na. No?
Oh, tsaka nakakahiya yung girlfriend mo may trabaho ikaw wala.
Correct.
It puts down his ego parang oy, ako kumikita, yeah, ikaw hindi.
What kind of job could he possibly get?
That's
21.
True. I know.
I mean, really, I like you're not going to go out and get a career. What it is they started young, that's it, and they're done. Every relationship at that age has to end after 2 or 3 years anyway. That's just the law of the land. I mean, you try to get in a few relationships so you can, you know, beef up the resume and get more experience in life. Taking a break.
Back to this way.
Yeah, but whatever.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
I have a new best friend who's always in the know. She knows the latest shopping finds and the most popular night spots to flaunt them. She helps me plan movie dates and my next Borkata getaway. She even helps me keep up with my guys' hobbies and gizmos, the latest bands and gigs, and what restos I have to try next. It's great having a best friend who knows everything. Meet Christine, my digital go-to girl. Log on to Christine.com and get everything a girl needs to know. Also available on iOS and Android.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the podcast here on this Monday night. It is the 17th of December, if you just tuned in. Our new phone number for the podcast as we kick off season two is 478-7954. If you want to get on the program, you have a question about your love life, your sex life, it could be anything, your career. We take all calls here on the show. Our guest tonight, of course, is John Lapus. We'll talk about John and his career move recently. I was reading on the paper that you moved to ABS-CBN or you went
yes,
and you moved
I'm
back to ABS-CBN.
Yes, yes, yes.
That's right. So we'll talk a little bit about that once we knock out some more of these phone calls. Dr. Ken is here as well. Thanks for downloading this show. If you just came back to the podcast, we appreciate it very much. 20 million downloads we did in season one, and I do not see why we wouldn't do as much again. again this coming season. All right, so let's get to these phone calls. Again, phone number 478-7954. My name is Mo. I am broadcasting from Los Angeles, the group right there at Beyond the Box Studios in Rockwell, Makati. Nico, who's on line 4, is 27 years old. He's been on hold the longest, and let's go ahead and talk to Nico. Nico, welcome to the show. What's up?
Hi.
Nico, I can hear something in your voice that makes me think you're gay.
Yeah,
that's right. See, that's the superpower, John. Do you see that? Yeah, I can hear it already.
Powerful, you know.
Ken, in a few months, you'll be able to knock him out. No worries. Okay. All right, Nico, 27. Your guest here tonight is John Lapus, so he might even have a better opinion than I on whatever your question is. What's going on? What's the problem?
Kasi ganito po. Meron akong parang body tropa. Tropa kami ganyan. Mm. Pero parang gusto ko siya ganyan. Mm. So, we used to hang out every day after office, ganyan. Mm. Actually, kanina nga lang, nagkasama ko lang kami kasi tinuruan niya ako ng dance. Mm. Ayun po, parang...
Are you openly gay? You don't sound openly gay. Kasi you, parang, close, I think what it is, it's like this is one... Close, yeah, this is one of your guy friends like.
Out ka?
No.
Okay, hindi ka out. Right. Yung friend mo sinasabi, straight ba yan o gay?
Straight.
Yeah, hindi niya alam bakla ka.
Yun ang problema. Ano ba yan? Kasi bakla siya, hindi siya out. Natatypan, ang type niya ay isang friend na straight. Uh-huh. Bilang hindi ka out, iha, anak, ang feeling nung straight na yan, barkada-barkada kayo, body-body.
So,
what's the question?
So, ang dilema mo ngayon na gusto mo na mag-open sa kanya, yun ba yun?
Yeah. Actually, ganun po.
Okay, ikaw ba handa ka sa kasagutan? Kasi if you're willing to take the risk, dalawa lang naman ang pwedeng sagot niyan. Una, na mas malaki ang chance, sasabihin niya na naku, straight ako, hindi ako bumapatol sa bakla, barkada na lang tayo. Or pangalawa...
John? Hmm. No. And he's gonna get punched in the face.
Hoy, sobra ka naman. Wala naman siyang ginagawa, yes. Siguro.
That's the way it works. If you've been my friend... Listen, if you've been my friend na barkada, tapos all of a sudden you're like, pare, I've had feelings.
Sabay ba kayo nagsha-shower? Bakit?
Punch in the face.
Hindi naman.
Oh, gaano ba kayo ka-close? Oh, hindi naman.
Hindi naman ganun ka-close, that close.
Kasi kung di mo na makayanan ang iyong nararamdaman, go ahead, sabihin mo sa
kanya. No, John, you're talking about the barangay behavior in the inner barangay, right?
Okay.
This is not subdivision behavior, okay? This is not like, the guy's from Paranaque, but it's not like alabang behavior na, bro, pare, I like you. Oh, you're gay, pala. Okay, bro, let's just be friends, bro. In the fucking inner barangay, if you go, pare, alam mo, matinik kaibigan tayo, mga 5 meters na tayo, nag-iinuman, nag-chicks, pero pare, I love you. Suntok sa mukha. That's how it works in inner barangay, man. Oy, Ken, am I right?
Mukha bang violent yung crush mo?
Hindi naman. Maamo naman.
Talaga mo? Tinatakot mo
yung
tao.
Baka gusto. I'm just saying, there's a difference in barangay behavior and subdivision behavior. And subdivision behavior, it's, okay, bro, it's okay, man. I understand, I'm good looking. Of course you like me. I'm fun
straight.
To be around.
Oh, yan nga yung second.
Yeah, but I'm straight, man. I don't mean to hurt your feelings. But in the barangay, on the streets, you do that shit, you're gonna get your ass kicked.
Oo naman. Yeah, pero ito mukha naman mabait at edukado naman itong caller natin at mukhang edukado rin yung friend
Nico,
niya.
Nico, do you live in the barangay or do you live in the subdivision?
No, subdivision.
There you go.
Oh, well, social.
I think the point is, like what John and Mo said, there is a risk. That's what John is saying. But what Mo is saying, there is a great risk.
That's getting your ass kicked.
Correct. In the different magnitude that John is describing, there is a risk. You can, fall out like
Dr.
As friends.
Ken,
yes.
Doc.
Yes, Mo.
Which scenario is more likely now that you've heard this guy? Mm. Is it John Lapus' scenario na maiintindihan niya or is it my scenario na
sasabakin siya?
Mabubugbog siya.
Well, from what he gave as a background for this guy, mabait naman daw. So it's subdivision, like what you were describing, as opposed to barangay. Right. So it's something that's in between. Right. It's like, hindi ka na lang niya papansinin rather than susuntukin ka niya.
Correct. ang tanong ko sa iyo ngayon, Iha, ikaw ba willing ka no na pag sinabi mo sa kanya ang tunay mo nararamdaman, eh iiwasan ka na niya at mawawala na siya habang buhay sa buhay mo? Or pwede ka na ganyan na magkaibigan kayo, hindi niya alam na bakla ka, at least pagsabay kayong umiihi, nakikita mo pa nagpapagpag siya ng tite, okay ba yun?
Eh kaso magkatrabaho sila eh.
Siguro ano lang, hindi ko na sasabihin.
Hindi mo na lang sasabihin kasi ayaw mo siyang mawala. Kasi malaki ang chance na mawala yan sa buhay mo. Iiwasan ka na niya pag nalamang bakla ka.
Nico, I have a question.
Lahat sa mga, yung mga racket-racket, siya yung kasama ko, mga kabadi ko siya sa mga ganun. Tinasama ko siya.
Homophobic ba siya?
Oo.
Homophobic ba siya?
Galit ba sa bakla? Hindi naman.
Hindi naman.
Ay, hindi naman pala.
He's friendly naman sa lahat ng tao.
Ayun ang sabi niya.
Habang nag-imisang uminom kayo, tapos mag-ano ka, mga mag...
It all comes down to they're part of a subdivision, and this is subdivision behavior. You're gonna be fine. If it was barangay behavior, you're gonna get punched in the fucking nose and the throat, and maybe punched in the heart as well, okay?
That's right.
Have you been with a man before, Nico?
Yeah.
Ayun pala.
Yeah. Oo, hindi naman porke closet, hindi na nakikipag-sex. Actually, yung mga ganyang closet, sila yung madaming araw-araw. Punta lang sa gym yan mga yan, sa Sinihan, sa Quezon City Circle, may hada yan mga yan. Eh.
Alright. Thanks for the call, buddy.
Okay, thank you.
Right. Kaya mo good luck with you and your best friend. Pag-pray natin yan, darling. You could do this.
Nico, you're gonna get punched in the fucking face. I'm telling you right now. I don't give a fuck. No, listen, there's no such thing as fucking barangay behavior and a subdivision behavior. There's you've been my best friend all this time. Sidekick kita sa lahat mga racket, tapos gaganin mo, putang ina, punch in the face. That's
right. Malay mo naman, nirespeto naman niya yung tao, ikaw talaga.
No. Nico, when you take the advice of Ken here and John, put one of those mouth guards that you see NBA players. Put that in your mouth first and then say, so when you get punched in the fucking face, you don't lose teeth. That's all. Matt, you're 19. QC on line 2. Hey, what's up, Matt?
Hey, guys. Good evening. Merry Christmas and congratulations.
Merry Christmas, Matt. Thank you, sir. I appreciate that. How can I help you?
Basically, since malapit ng Christmas season, and then I just have a limited budget, what ideas can you give me para sa present ko for my mom?
How much is your budget?
Around 1K.
Oh, that's barangay behavior also.
Wait, sobra ka naman. Baka naman estudyante pa yung call si Matt. Nag-aaral ka pa ba, Matt?
Yes.
Oh, estudyante pa. Nagtipid siya ng baon. 1,000 para lang makaipon siya para regalo sa nanay niya. Oh, bilang nanay mo.
Listen.
Alam mo, bilang...
Matt.
Oh.
Matt, you take that 1,000, you buy groceries, you go online, and you find the greatest recipe of all time, and you try your best to be a fucking fantastic chef, and you prepare something for her.
Ah, that's a good idea. That's a good idea. That's a good idea.
Moms are not materialistic when it comes to what their children.
Mas gusto ng nana yung nag-exert ka ng effort na gawin.
That's right.
Kaysa binibili.
You know, even if you want, you know, as you may know in my past of videotaping, you might even want to document the whole thing. Like, Mom, nandito ako sa may palengke, at bibili kita ng mga fresh fruit. You know, it could be kind of like an entertaining type of thing because that's free. I mean, you can record that on your cell phone, right?
Tapos ipakita niya sa Christmas Day.
Yes, it's like if you're good in computers, like iMovie, you could gather all her pictures.
iMovie. Tanya, 1,000 lang ang kipera, tapos iMovie sinasabi mo. That's Mac shit, man.
Baka meron niya siyang Mac, tapos 1,000 lang ang pera niya. Baka meron lang, you know?
Okay, post mo na lang sa Facebook.
But that's something
good. He's got $1,000 and you're telling him, on your MacBook Pro, this is what you need to do, okay? You need to... Jesus Christ, man.
Oh, okay, basta yun, yung suggestion namin, mag-something na lulutuin na lang, gano'n.
Yan, pasta, gano'n.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
Okay lang.
You're welcome.
Yeah, it's okay. It's the heartfelt stuff. When it comes to the moms, it's the heartfelt stuff.
Correct.
Now, if you have a 19-year-old girlfriend and your budget is 1,000, I'm telling you, you're in trouble. But with the mom, it's all what you can do for her, and you know how she you make her feel, how you show your love for her after all of these years.
Effort, bigay mo sa kanya yung pera niya, tapos.
Simple, diretso.
Oh. Mami Junisha ang peg, no? Parang, kailangan ko na ma-admess.
Away, akin na yung pera. Merry Christmas, anak. Thank you.
Ganun. Cash na lang.
That's right. Thanks, Matt. Appreciate your call, man. Have a good one. All right, John. I promised I'd interview you about your career a little bit before we wrap this up.
Oh, yes.
So you moved from GMA back to ABS where you first started. I know at least a lot of your friends are ABS friends anyway, directors, writers. I remember when I first met you, you were amongst the barkada sa ABS that ran things. Para kayong mga mafia in ABS with all of your friends.
I'm so happy to actually be working again with my friends and most of them, mga directors na, mga executive na, mga big boss na sa ABS-CBN. And I'm so happy. So last Thursday lang ito nangyari. I'll be coming back home with the unit of Deyo. And Rinaldo was always been my boss in ABS-CBN. You know that, Mo. So,
pero right.
Soap opera naman muna yung gagawin ko. I'll be doing a soap opera. We start taping this Thursday starring Angeline Quinto, Sam Melby, and Paolo Avellino. Kahit konting pagtingin there. That's the title. It's slated on January 2013. So, yung mga solid kapamilya out there, please watch out for it. Ayan. And
now, I've been in ABS. Mm-hmm. I did two stints in ABS. I did two stints in GMA. And then I did one stint on TV5. So, mm-hmm. I've been able to be on all the networks, right?
Correct. And pareho tayo. Try natin tatlo.
Yeah. Right. As much as I love TV5 because the management was great. Mm-hmm. They paid very well. Mm-hmm. There's nothing like ABS, man. Like, I'm telling you right now, are you celebrities or you mga tao na gusto maging celebrity one day? The level that you want to get into is ABS-CBN success level.
Yeah. It's because that, the scope of ABS, it's so big, di ba? Silang unang pinalabas sa other country via TFC.
That's right.
Mas marami mga
Go on Twitter. Listen, go on Twitter, right? If you're a big Twitter person, check out who are the most followed people in Philippine personalities.
Yeah,
I'd say of the top 10, 9 of them are ABS.
Actually.
Maybe all 10 of them are ABS.
Oh, so hopefully ngayon, ha, dumami na yung mga Twitter followers ko. At Sweet John Lapus, yan din po ang pangalan ko
sa Instagram. No, exactly. Yeah, that's exactly what's gonna happen. You're gonna gain an extra 200,000 followers by the end of the month. Because look, ABS is a powerful, like, okay, even if the ratings say na GMA ang lamang and all of that stuff, there's nothing like being part of ABS. The facilities are great. Mm-hmm. The quality of the programming is very good. The biggest stars in the country are all ABS-CBN stars. When you watch like the TV shows like ASAP, nakita mo yung crisp, you know, picture that you see on TV compared to the other noontime shows. ABS
is an amazing organization. Grabe, ang ganda-ganda
na
ng loob ng ABS-CBN. Medyo mahigpit lang, di ka basta-basta makakapasok. But their studio,
right.
Their cameras are all HD.
Wow.
Tapos bawat sulok mo may flat screen na monitors na every corner of the building. Tapos ang bilis ng pangyayari. I was only there for supposed to be story conference lang. Apparently, the pictorial for the soap pala is set up na already downstairs. Tapos,
that's right. The thing though with ABS, the thing though, it's a very corporate feel. You know, I mean, it is, I think ABS is very much like what you would find in Hollywood. Not a lot of, even though it's called Kapamilya, I don't feel like there's a lot of family connection between everyone over there.
Not,
I know you have kasi
not in my case because I started there, diba? So
that's right. That's what I was saying. So, but aside from that, if you're a celebrity and you're new in the industry and you're in ABS, hindi mo mafeel yung camaraderie that you would feel in other stations like the GMAs and the TV5. But who cares? When your shows are great,
correct.
You have your own fucking dressing room in TV5 or GMA. You're not gonna get your own dressing room. You're gonna share it with 10 other fucking celebrities. ABS, you have your own. Or if not your own, you and your friends.
Talentadong Pinoy worldwide naman in TV5. That's every Saturday, ha. And yun lang. Right. So happy and excited. And I would like to take this opportunity, Mona, to promote na rin. I have a Metro Manila Film Festival entry this Christmas. Si Agimat, si Enting Cabisote at si ako. Bong Revilla, Bossing Vic Soto, and Judy Ann Santos. Three biggest stars in the industry in one movie. So please, guys, please watch
out. Let me ask you though about Metro Manila Film Fest, John. These movies that come out every year, it's the same franchise. Because kumikita sila, Enting Cabisote, huge. Shake, Rattle, and Roll, fine, huge.
Yes, yes.
But don't you think that because they're just doing the same franchise every year, that parang pumapangit yung MMFF because they're no longer being creative. They're just going with what sells. This kumikita ang Enteng, kumikita ang Shake Rattle, Shake Rattle 105.
Mo nag-exert naman ng effort yung mga writers, yung mga producers na iniiba naman. Like ito, I think this is the second or third installment of Agimat
Fourth.
Ending series or a franchise. So this time, iba naman kasi may Judy Ann Santos na tsaka I was reading the script. Talagang iba eh as compared to sa first two. Sa Shake Rattle din, ganun naman mo. Laging three stories, pero laging iba-iba every year. Ngayon nga, alam ko, kakaiba. Kasi dati, di ba, tatlo, iba-iba directors. Ngayon, yung tatlo, Chitoronyo lahat. So, maganda yung labanan din ngayon itong Metro Manila Film Festival this year na sa December 23 na nga po pala ang parada. Hindi na po yung the usual na December 24. So, at least, kami ngayon, di kami from the parada, diretsong Machubuena sa bahay. May rest na kami ngayon. So, kita-kita po tayo. The usual yan sa Meros Boulevard dyan magsisimula. December 33 po ang parada. At sana po, tangkilikin po ninyo ang lahat ng entry dito sa darating na Metro Manila Film Festival. Pakiunan nyo na lang po yung si Agimat, si Ending Cabisote at si ako. Andyan po ako. Maganda role ko dyan.
Fair enough.
Bonga. All right.
Good luck.
Taking a break. When we come back, we will choose who our caller of the night is. They might win an iPhone 5 from Globe. Lovely. Taking a commercial break. When we come back, we'll give you that surprise and we'll decide who we thought was the best for the night. Season 2, Episode 1. Thanks for being here. Thanks for downloading it. We appreciate it very much. We have shows every weeknight here on this podcast. So make sure to subscribe to it. Don't go away.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
I have a new girl who lets me do what I love.
She updates me on new star athletes to watch for and the teams that are just killing it. She helps me plan which games to catch with the guys or the next marathon we can join. She teaches me how to condition myself for sports, which cool music to work out to, and where I can go on my next adventure. A girl who loves what I love. She's Christine, my digital go-to girl. Log on to Christine.com and get more out of what you love. Also available on iOS and Android.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the show. Thanks for being here on our first episode of Season 2 on this Monday night. It is a week to go before Christmas. So Merry Christmas to all of you. Make sure to spread the word about this podcast. You can subscribe to it on iTunes. Just look it up. Good Times with Mo podcast. We have a lot of other podcasts, by the way, that is produced by the company. So we'll go ahead and plug some of those. Maybe tomorrow. We'll see if we can plug some of those tomorrow so you can kind of get to know some of the other stuff that's under the New Media Factory. No longer Battle Axe, but you know, we're like sister companies. And definitely check out those other podcasts. I want to thank our guest here tonight, John Lapus, for being here. John, you can follow him on Twitter, Sweet John Lapus, and you've seemed to get a steady growth of followers. I remember you're very new to Twitter. I mean, what has it been, only like months since you started?
Oh.
And now you're well over 140,000 or something like that.
I'm so thankful nga na overwhelmed ako na I'm less than a year in Twitter and yet meron na akong 159,000 followers. Pwede na yun, di ba?
That's awesome. That's
madami na yun, ha? Thank you very much, guys. I appreciate it a lot.
All right. Let us get to the caller of the night. But before that, we had one final call that we forgot to take. And let's go ahead and put him on now. He's 32 years old. His name's Wes from Parañaque. He just broke up with his girlfriend of 8 years. So he's probably fucking dying online. Wes,
yes,
what's
sir?
Up? Wes.
Yes, Mo. Wesley.
Yeah, go. Yeah, Wesley. All right, sorry, Wesley. All right, well, what's going on? You have a problem.
Yeah, my GF broke up with me last month after 8 years. And yep. It's a long-distance relationship.
Okay.
So after 3 years of being apart, she decided not to pursue anymore. I think
sure.
We are going to a different direction, but I still love her. So, like, is there anything?
Wes... listen, and I say this advice to a lot of people who get into the long distance relationship. You have to prepare yourself that you guys are going to break up every long distance relationship because it's very difficult to pull off. Even though it's easier now than ever because of technology, the long distance relationship, I'm going to say maybe 15% of them succeed and the rest of them go to shit. So if you're currently listening to this podcast and you're in a long distance relationship, you have to prepare in your mind that this is going to end one day. Because people need to be touched, people need to be held, people need a dick in their mouth, people need that kind of physical interaction. And if she's far away, and how far is she? Where is she? And compared to you, obviously.
Yeah, here in Philippines. She's in Singapore.
That's not far.
It's far. It's expensive, man. I mean, listen, for eight, how many years? 3 years you've been doing this already?
8 years.
No, 8 years together. Three years of long distance.
Yeah.
Okay, if it was like Philippines, Saudi, something like that, you would last 5 months, 6 months, you know, 8 months. If it's Singapore, you last a year and a half. I mean, that's about it. 3 years, it's supposed to be like this. Very, very rarely do you see, especially if you guys are not married and you don't have kids. You know, it's not like that OFW thing where, you know, you have a whole family and, you know, parang, those things last a little longer because they're a family structure. She's just your girlfriend and 3 years long distance is very difficult to pull off. You have to prepare your mind. You have to prepare yourself that it's going to fail.
Oh, yeah. But actually, this is the first time I open it up to somebody.
Yeah.
Unless you're willing to do something about it, like moving there, or she's going
to
go back here.
You have to do something. But you should have moved there a long time ago.
The farther it is, the shorter you're going to break up. The closer it is, you're going to take longer for you to break up, but you're still going to break up. I agree with Mo.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wesley, it really is the way it is. Now, you can call her and say, listen, babe, sayang yung 8 years. We're in our 30s already. It should have been you and me. Yeah. If I go to Singapore, are you willing to give it another chance? Just because I think you're worth it. I think you're worth me relocating there. We are worth it. And see what she says. If she says no, that means she wanted to break up like a year ago. She was just kind of holding on because it's sayang yung 8 years. If she says yes, it's because the long distance is very taxing. And if somebody makes the decision and the sacrifice to go somewhere else for another person, that can save the relationship. But you have to be clear about that with her first.
Who wants to break up? The girl?
I'm sure she break. Yeah,
okay, I have one question. Yeah. Is there a third party?
No.
Singapore? Okay. Nah.
Yeah, just a simple question.
Distance lang talaga.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. It's different if it's like Hong Kong. I mean, I would say third party. If it was something like that, but Singapore? Yeah.
The statuses, because she's already 3 years there, so she's more like financially stable compared to my work here. So
call her. Just say, hey, listen, if I go over there and I get a job, and you know, are we going to do this? We're in our 30s, you know, sayang din yung 8 years. You can say all of those things and see if she'll take you back. If not, she probably wanted to break up with you about a year ago already.
Yes,
just because
thank you very much, Mo. Yeah, thank you for
Wesley.
That optimistic. Thank you very much.
Well, it's optimistic / more realistic that these things end. I mean, that's the negative part of it. It ends. Long distance relationships, they end. Thanks, though. We appreciate your call. Let's go to our caller of the night. Let's see if she wins a Globe iPhone 5. And speaking of Globe, before we get her on the program, I want to remind everyone that to do your part as a citizen, as a Filipino, by donating as much as you can to the relief efforts of Typhoon Pablo, of course, which happened recently down south. Let these victims, the people who are displaced, the people suffering, the people who lost a lot, let them know it's Christmas time, as the song goes. Donate via GCash. All you got to do is text donate the amount, Pablo, and you send it to 2882. And hopefully, you know, you can do that, and it'll definitely help them out because they really had a hard time down south because of the typhoons that we always get here in the country. Okay, our caller of the night, we talked about it. We all had different opinions, but when we brought up her name, we said, oh, yeah, she was good. So let's talk to Justine, who's 22. She's the one who had the boyfriend who was boning girls from Craigslist.
Correct.
And she's going to be the caller of the night. Hopefully, she wins a Globe iPhone 5. We also have some cash there, $5,000 that she could win.
Wow.
And we have a set of 5 movie passes. So the theme is fives. iPhone 5, $5,000. Or 5 movie passes to Eastwood. Thank you, Eastwood, for making it happen.
Five sardinas lang.
Or we can give you 5 sardinas. Actually, that'd be even better because that's cheaper for us. Let's put her on. Justine?
Hello, Justine. Andiyan ka ba?
Justine.
I think we lost it.
Justine, magparamdam ka.
All right, never mind. You know what? Why don't we just, we can end the show now, and then off air we'll have Justine select from the three boxes, and then we'll give her whatever prize she wins. Tomorrow on the show we have Mocha, and your chance at winning another Globe iPhone 5 with a 1 year waived bill. That's the 2,500 peso monthly bill is waived, paid for. So 1 whole year you have no bills to pay when it comes to cell phones, and you get the iPhone 5, which just launched, and get it via Globe, because really, what a deal Globe's got for the iPhone 5.
Dok, handa ka na ba kay Mocha? Diba si Mocha yung nagpapahipo o nagpapakita? Ano ba yung ginagawa ni Mocha nung huli? Diba?
Yeah, I saw that.
Nagpakita ba o nagpahipo?
Pareho.
Good luck, Doc. Oh,
hindi nagpapanti yan. On Wednesday, we have Erwan Husoff, for all you people who love culinary, good-looking guys. I mean, he's a nice, smart young man. On Thursday, we have Denise Laurel, who's going to be on the program. Mm-hmm. And on Friday, we have Dr. Hayden Ko on the program. That's the week's worth of...
Sabihin mo kay Hayden Ko, yung mag-re-enact ng mga video-video niya rito. Pag umuho, pupunta ulit ako dito sa Friday. Di ba pwede yun?
Let me ask you, John. Oh. Kasi yung mga co-host ko sa radio, ala naman si Susie, di ba? Sabi ni Susie daw, nung nakita niya, napanood niya yung mga sex video daw ni Hayden and stuff, maliit daw titi ni Hayden. I'm like, really?
Mm-mm, for his height, yes. It's small. For his height.
Really?
Yes. For his height, and ang height ni Hayden, siguro mga 6'1 yun, ano? 6'2, matangkat
eh. No, 6'4.
O, 6'4 pa pala. Tapos,
it's a big guy.
Ang laki ng paa. That's small yon for his ano, for his body.
Really? I never. Let me ask you, Ken, Doc Ken. When it comes to size, height, I mean, there's not supposed to be correlation with penis size, right?
Well, you know the answer to this. You're the penis expert, and I've heard you talk about this. And it really depends on the race of the person.
That's right.
And it seems like
Hayden,
is he like a mix also? Or just pure Filipino?
Pinoy ata lang.
Oh, no, Chinese. Chinese. Last name's Ko.
Well, Chinese didn't help either, right?
Ah, baka.
That's right.
So it has to be like Caucasian.
Hindi, tsaka din yung totoo. Ako, di ba mahili ko sa mga basketball player, mga hada ko, 6'1, 6'2, 6'3, 6'4.
Here we go.
Nakahada ko ng 6'4, malaki pa nota ko, nakakaloka.
There you go.
Pinauwi ko nga.
Pinauwi.
Oo, ito pa masahe, thank you for coming.
We have a...
Nakahada na. Kaya ako naniniwala.
Mag-taxi ka na.
Kaya ako, Doc, naniniwala ako sa sinasabi ni itong kaibigan ko si Mo Twisa. Hindi tayo sa magkaibigan kami. Na malaki ang nota niya for his size. Kasi nakahada na ako ng sinliit ni Mo Twisa. Pero ang laki ng nota. Kasi nang nasabi ko talaga, ikaw ba may ari niyan? Nagulat ako talaga. Yeah. Kaya pag sinasabi ni Mo na malaki size niya, naniniwala ako.
Does he also shave?
Ay, di ko lang alam dito. Ewan ko. Sabi ko kay Mo, minsan pakita niya na sa akin para matapos na to.
Sabi
diba?
Niya kasi, sinishave
mabuti
niya para.
Mabuti ako na talaga magsasabi sa publiko na confirm, malaki po ang nota ng kaibigan kong si Mo Twister kahit maliit lang siya. Tapos.
There you go.
Ay, ano, picturean mo ngayon Mo, padala mo sa akin.
Okay, let me ask you, John. Hayden or I? Who's got the bigger unit?
Sino daw?
Who?
Hayden or me?
Hayden or Mo?
Hindi ko mga nakita yung nota mo, di ba? Tinatanong kita, sabi ko sa iyo, matagal na, ipakita mo na para matapos ato yung issue na to, di ba? Maraming hindi naniniwala pag sinasabi mo malaki yung nota mo. Eh, hindi ko pa nakita.
Sinasabi yun?
ikunan mo rin ang video yung sarili mo, tapos pagkukumpare ko sa video ni Hayden para magkaalaman na, ha?
Judge my junk.
O kaya, sa really? Friday, Mo, prangkahan na tayo. Sa Friday, guest mo siya rito, pakita lang, kasi Doc lang titingin kung sino mas mahaba. Diba? Madali. Ako, or papuntahin niyo ako nasusukat.
So you wanna do Friday. John, you'll come back on the show on Friday. Papakita mo ang titi mo kay Doc. Tapos si Hayden, papakita niya ang titi niya kay Doc. Tapos palakihin tayo, parang ganun?
Mo, ha?
Parang kinabahan
ka. Hoy! Nota mo, ha? DJ mo, hindi akin. Huwag mo ako idamay dyan. Ako, taga-sukat lang ako. Taga-sabi lang ako kung sino. By that time, may camera ka naman na makikita ka na namin. Diba?
Oh. John, kailangan natin i-baptize yung bagong doktor natin, no? So, kailangan na mangyari ngayon. Bago tayo mag-goodbye, pakita mo naman titi mo kay Kit Ken.
Excuse me!
Doktor siya! Punta ka na doktor yan! That's a doctor!
So, yung nga, hindi ko pinapakita nota ko. Dito ba kay doctor ka? Kilala lang namin. Ako, tingnan mo ako.
Just stop this barangay behavior and just show him your penis. He's a doctor.
Ang baboy mo bakla ako, no? Nakakaloka ka kung...
Kung babuyin mo, hindi ako si Mocha. Dok, si Mocha, yun, magpapakita ng suso at saka ng keps yun, papahit yun. Day.
Kaya kinakabahan
ako. Ihanda mo na katawan mo bukas.
You have a jealous wife? Ken?
I'm sorry?
You have a jealous wife?
Yes, I do.
Patay.
You picked the wrong show to be on. You are fucking... Huwag
mo banggitin na nandito ka.
Mocha's gonna dry hump your ass tomorrow. Yeah, it's gonna be fucking crazy. You should better wear some sort of metal dick guard because she is gonna be all over you. It's
yung may lock na para sa nota.
Yeah, you better lock that ball down. She's gonna... Yeah.
She's also a doctor, but yeah. She's also a jealous doctor.
Listen, I'll say it already now. We need a new doctor on the show. After your wife makes you quit this program, you should already take a thing. You're fucking dead, man. Especially when she gets here tomorrow.
Si bago natin doc, si Doc Ken.
Salamat, Jan.
Yeah, I liked Ken. I think you did a good job today, Ken.
I'm sorry.
But again, you're not going to last on this program because Mocha's going to fucking dry rape you tomorrow and your wife will pull you out.
Yeah, that's what you think.
Nanggagahasa pa
metal
si
dick guard. Remember, that's what I said. Metal dick guard tomorrow on the show.
All right.
Want to wrap it up. I want to thank everyone for downloading the podcast. If you do via iTunes, we appreciate it very much. Again, I apologize. I wasn't feeling very well today, so kind of a less energy because I've been coughing the whole program. I just had to put it on mute. Hopefully, you know, I'll be in better health tomorrow, and we can have a little bit more energy from my side. So, thanks for the staff who are back as well. They do such a great job. They did such a great job in season one, and it's just nice to see the familiar faces manning the production side on that part. And Basti Artadi, of course, of Wolfgang, also there helping out today. Thanks, Basti. Oh, man. That's very kind of you.
Ni Basti Artadi rito, pakalat-kalat lang sa harapan ko. Sanggali mag-Tagalog.
Yeah, he's awesome. Talo Dr. Ken pa? As well. John Lapus, thank you so much. And John, you were on the podcast three times last year. Let's have you on the podcast regularly this year as well. I know you're very busy now with your new ABS stint, but...
Sabi ko naman sa'yo, dito sa podcast mo, mas posible akong mag-guess kesa doon sa radio show mo na umaga. Alam mo naman, patulog pa lang ako noon. Pero itong podcast mo, late naman. So, mapapadalas ako rito. So, lahat po ng mga nagda-download ngayon, nakikinig, nanonood ngayon itong Good Times with Mo podcast. So, I'll be back. Promise po yan sa inyo. So, thank you.
Support. John in his ABS-CBN career and of course the Metro Manila Film Fest film that he's in, Enteng Cabezote, number 47 he's on of course this
47.
Alright, wrapping it up, have a great day guys, we'll see you tomorrow on the podcast. This has been Mo and Good Times with Mo season 2 episode 1.
Good Times with Mo, the podcast, was executively produced by Mohan Gulata, engineered by Miguel Alfindo, and operated by Icon Media Inc.
Special thanks to Magic 89.9. You can follow Mo on Twitter at www.twitter.com/DJMoTwister.
Email him at goodtimeswithmopodcast@rocketmail.com.